One of the handiest new features in Python 3.14 is what's called the external debugger interface. You can take a running Python program and connect to it with another Python program for live debugging. And you don't have to modify the target program in any way. As long as you're using Python 3.14, you can do this. This makes it a lot easier to do live interaction with running code, such as code that's already been deployed to production. So let's see an example of how this would work in practice. Let's start with a simple program that just prints in a loop and sleeps every so often. At the top of this script, I print out the process ID for our program. This is how we're going to get access to it through the external debugger interface. We need to know its process ID, and this is the simplest way to do that. Once we start our program and make a note of the ID, we then have this other program here, which is basically just a stub. And what it does is use a new command, sys.remoteexec, to take the process ID and use that to inject this other script that we have written into it. So when we do that, you'll notice that our main program's execution is interrupted. And the code that we injected, as you can see here, is asking for a new value for the time to sleep. And the way we get access to that through our injected code is by importing the main module. And main, in this case, contains the main module for the program that we have injected our code into. This gives us access to everything in that program's namespace. So with it, we can get a new value for sleep time from the user, and then modify the value for sleep time in the running code. So if I type 2 for our new sleep value here, and then -1 to exit the loop for the injected code, you'll now see that our running code will sleep for 2 seconds at each loop instead of 1 second. And that's only one tiny example of how we can use this new interface to examine and modify a running Python process. You could easily write a whole remote injectable command console specific to an app that lets you jump in and make modifications specific to that program without having to stop it and restart it. Actually, we already have a very good general purpose interface of that kind in Python. It's the PDB, or the Native Python Debugger. And as of Python 3.14, it can be used with this new debugging interface. So let's restart our applications and use a different command to connect to it. py-3.14 m pdb p and then the process ID. This launches PDB and passes it a process ID to connect to. After a pause to spin up the debugger, we get the PDB command line interface. And by the way, when we invoke that, this pauses the execution of the target program. So now we can use PDB's own commands to work with the program. For instance, we type S, and that will single step, line by line, through the code. And as we single step, you'll notice that the PDB interface will also pause whenever the target program sleeps. That's normal and unavoidable. If the target program is doing something that requires waiting on something else, we don't have any choice but to wait for it. PDB also gives us the ability to interact with the target program in a Python prompt. So if we type interact, we get dropped into the familiar Python REPL. And here, again, we can import the main module, just like we did in the other injected program we wrote, and we can use that to modify the value of sleep time. Once we've done that, if we type continue, you'll see that our sleep time is now 2 seconds per loop. We can then exit the debugger if we like and allow the original program to keep running. Again, all this is a very rudimentary set of examples for how the new debugging interface can be used. But the most powerful and promising thing about it is that we don't need to modify our source to take advantage of it. Any running Python program on the 3.14 interpreter can be inspected and manipulated this way. And what's more, this is a Python native solution. This is not something that we would need a third-party dependency for. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.